G'day, g'day. How are we, team? As mentioned in a previous video, I just recently picked up a Nintendo Switch. So I've got a few games I've picked up that I want to talk to you about. A couple of little ones that I've found that I'm enjoying, some more than others. But what I want to talk to you about today is, see if we can get the focus right there, but it is Trials Rising on the Switch. Focus isn't going to come through. It's also on Xbox, PlayStation as well. The camera's not going to focus on it, but it's a little motorbike game. Pretty simple in essence, but I've had a bunch of fun with it. It's pretty addictive in what I've had experience with so far, but it's easy to pick up. One of those hard to master games though. So you get into it really, really quick. Because the tutorial, they've kind of gamified the tutorial a little bit as far as you can get ratings with different skill games and things like that. And as you progress through the game, you'll unlock harder skill games that that teach you how to do different moves, like get over different objects and how to flow with jumps and things like that. So I think they've done it really well in that sense of educating you along the way as you go. As you get up into the harder levels, they give you the tutorials and the tools then that you need, as opposed to giving you the entire tutorial of everything right at the start. They've kind of staggered it and staged it. But then, yeah, you get a score and a rating for every tutorial as good as you do from F all the way through to A+. I'm pretty sure it is. So they've done that really, really well. As I said, you can get into it in a couple of minutes, and the trials only take a couple of minutes to do. So it's a really cool little, if you're on a plane, on a bus, or traveling somewhere, you've only got half hour, not even that, even just 20 minutes. You can just jump in, have a couple of games and have a bit of fun there, which is cool. There's plenty of stuff to do. There's a bunch of aesthetic stuff you can unlock, which, yeah, it's kind of cool. I don't really get too involved in that side of things. There's only a handful of different bikes, but I think there's more updates coming on the way where there'll be more bikes to be able to update through there. The gameplay's pretty addictive. There's a few different things. There's just the normal trials, which take a couple of minutes, and then there's more of a tournament style races the races are a lot shorter, but you'll start off in a field of eight and you've got to reach the top four to progress to the next stage, and then you've got to reach the top two to progress to the final, which is a one-on-one race. So that's kind of fun as well. And there's some random funny skill games too. So that might be jumping in and going down a ramp, and then there's a bunch of explosive barrels, and you've got to bail off your bike, hit the explosive barrel, and see how far you can travel, and you get a different rating for how far you travel. So that's, yeah, kind of fun, and you can muck around with that a little bit. When you get up to the hard and extreme levels, it becomes much, much more difficult. So that ties into the hard to master side of things. But as I said, I've had a bunch of fun with it. This is only going to be a real short video. It's a pretty simple game. It's a great little time waster. It's essentially, there's not a huge amount of depth to the gameplay. Sort of, it's whether it's skill games or the tutorials and the normal trials or the little tournament sort of stuff. Essentially, it is all very, very similar gameplay, but I've had a bunch of fun with it. So to give it a ratings in the normal rating systems that we use here, learning curve, I gave it an 8. It's pretty simple. As I said, it's easy to pick up, but difficult to master, but pretty straightforward. It's not super complicated. Some of the harder skills to learn towards the hard and extreme levels can get a little bit frustrating. There have been a couple of times where I've been trying to do the same level and just restarting it over and over and over again for a fair while, and had to put it down and walk away from it. But yeah, 8 out of 10 for the learning curve. You pick it up pretty quick. Time to start, I gave it a 9 out of 10, because you jump in, you get straight into it. You pick a race, a game, or a tutorial, and away you go. So 9 out of 10 for that, which is great. Session time, I gave it a 10. As I said, because you can jump in, you can play it for 10 minutes, do a couple of trials, boom, done. Sweet, had that gone. But I've also spent an hour and a half playing it straight, just getting right into it. It's pretty addictive in that sense. The gameplay, I gave it a 7, just because, like I said, there's not a huge amount of depth, but it's really, really fun to play. And they've done it with the physics in it. It is pretty cool. They've done it really, really well. Replayability, gave it a 5, just because tying into the gameplay, that there's not a huge amount of depth to it, you can get into that feeling of I'm just doing the same thing over and over and over again. But there's plenty of variety in the courses and stuff that you get to do with a bunch of different things, but there's not a huge amount of depth. There's no storyline or anything like that really to it, so don't expect anything like that. So overall for me, that's a 7.8 out of 10 on that one. So that's pretty good. Like I said, it's a fun little time waster. I'm really enjoying it. The controls on the Switch are a little bit hard to be super accurate. You got to do some really, really sort of slow and gentle throttle control at times, which can be a little bit hard with the smaller thumbsticks on the Switch. Then you don't have as much room to be accurate like on the PlayStation or the Xbox controllers. So I can assume on the Xbox and PlayStation, you can probably be a little more accurate, whereas you do get accidentally go a little bit too far sometimes, I find, with my big thumbs on the Switch. So that's something to consider as well. But for me, I think it's a fantastic little game. I picked it up, I think it was on, it's been out for a while now, so I got it for like $25, I think, like something like that, from EB Games on special. So for me, it was a bargain. And I think if you're into your sort of sport platformer type and platformer type games and motorbikes, you probably have a bunch of fun with this. I love it. So that was Trials Rising.